Hey, it's John Terry with Vision Advisors, and welcome to another Selling Secrets of the Top 5%. This is Selling Secret number 29, and if you're old enough to remember the Beatles, you'll probably remember the line to this particular episode. One is the loneliest number that you'll ever know. And we want to add a caveat to that. Not only is it the loneliest number that you'll ever know, it's a number you, as a financial advisor, should avoid at all costs. The top 5% understand this, and they structure their business and their sales activities to make sure that this does not happen to them. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, number one, you're in the people business. As a financial professional, you make your living engaging with the public, being belly to belly with them, having a conversation about their money problems and the solutions that you can bring to the table. Now, as a licensed financial professional, you're also connected to insurance carriers, maybe one, maybe a dozen, maybe some number in between, but you have insurance carrier relationships that you work with. Now, you're also selling solutions. You're solving for an income problem, an accumulation problem, a risk management problem, a chronic healthcare problem. You pick the problem, you're there to create and present solutions to those problems for your clients. But in all of the things that you do, the top 5% understand something that 95% of average and mediocre sales professionals don't, or maybe they do, but they just don't do anything about it. There's one thing that you have to make sure you avoid. And what is that one thing? It's only having one. Now, what do I mean by that? There are a series of ones that you need to make sure that you are avoiding. The first of those is only using one marketing medium. If none of your customers are on Facebook and all of your marketing is to Facebook, you're sending the right message on the wrong platform. If your clients want to receive direct mail to respond to you and you're not using direct mail, again, you're missing the opportunity. Clients exist in multiple marketing mediums because they go to different sources for information. Just relying on one is something that the top 5% understand, 95% of those in the industry don't. Number two, if you are a seminar or an adult education professional, relying on only one venue to do your seminars or your adult education events. In the event you're using Ruth Chris as a steakhouse, and all of a sudden there is an issue and the health department shuts down Ruth Chris, there's a fire at the Ruth Chris restaurant, and you only have that one venue to use for your events, you've got a problem. Many of us learned during this coronavirus pandemic when a lot of organizational places that we use that could house bigger events were shut down, we had nowhere to go. And as a result of that, if you were not able to pivot to doing some type of online digital marketing to put your messages out there, you spent a lot of the year wondering what you were going to do next. Another one to avoid is only having one sales pitch. You only sell one product or one solution one way, and that's the only way you do it. Well, number one, one solution doesn't work for everybody. You can't make a round peg fit a square hole, but how many financial advisors today are stuck in this old school mindset that I only do life insurance, I only do annuities, I only do long-term care, or I can only sell a product with a bonus, I can only sell a product with an income rider. When you get that bias in the way, that becomes a one that's dangerous. Other financial professionals only rely on one specific carrier, or they have a pet product or a service that they like to sell. That can be dangerous, again, because one product doesn't solve every client need. Clients' needs are as diverse as the universe of products that we have. But if you're relying on one specific carrier and that carrier gets into an issue, I mean, we recently saw that with a carrier that went into receivership. They were selling product left and right, and all of a sudden, because of some financial issues, they went into receivership. That was a problem for the agencies and organizations that were involved with that. If you're selling a product or you're selling a service and you're sold on just selling one product or one service to everybody that you meet, number one, that product may or may not be in that client's best interest. And number two, What happens if that product is pulled from the market? Or if, as a result of a number of complaints, all of a sudden that product gets you in trouble because it truly isn't in the client's best interest? Now, others will say, well, I only do paper applications, or I'll only do e-app. Again, when you get a bias and you say, this is the only way I can do something, you are limiting your ability to see success. You have put a lid on your ability to scale and to grow your business. And then many of you may come in and you only work with one client. Maybe you're in the health insurance industry and you got one large association or one large employer group, and that makes up 70, 80, 90% of your business on a consistent and regular basis. What happens if that one big client goes away? The big question we have to ask as it relates to how we market, where we do our events, the type of sales pitch we're doing, carriers and products that we use, anything in our process, what happens if something happens to your one? What happens if this big giant hammer comes down and shatters that golden egg that is bringing money into your business every single week, every single month, year after year? If that model gets broken, what do you do? So here's something the top 5% have learned, and if you want to transition yourself into that 5% status and get that success mindset that's going to allow you to truly scale your business and to achieve a better outcome, here's a few things you need to make sure you're doing. Number one, don't get so caught up in the one that you miss the other opportunities around you. Now, one of the things we teach here at Vision Advisors is becoming an authority figure and an expert so that you are known for working in a specific marketplace. Maybe it's working with chiropractors. Maybe it's working with architects or engineers. Maybe it's working with entrepreneurs. Maybe it's plumbers or electricians. Don't get so caught up in just serving that one niche that you miss other opportunities to serve other clients that may not be your ideal client, but from time to time, they can have an opportunity to have you serve them and meet their needs, and it adds to your bottom line. You may discover now that you've got another unique niche. So now instead of just serving chiropractors, maybe you're serving chiropractors and dentists. Or maybe you're no longer just serving dentists, but now you're serving dentists and CPAs. As a result of not being caught up in just doing one, you may be able to create two or three unique niches that you have the opportunity to work in and be seen as an authority figure or an expert. And as a result of that, you can scale your business by broadening slightly the niche in which you worked. Now, another big thing, number two, is you want to make sure that you don't get fixated on one carrier. Yeah. XYZ, Volcanic Life, you pick the carrier that's out there. If you get fixated on one specific carrier and 80% of my business is going to carrier A or 90% of my business is there because you're simply trying to qualify for a trip or a bonus or some other unique benefit, remember, your number one goal is to solve the need of the customer. It is to provide the appropriate solution that is going to take care of their problem and is the best solution available for them at the time. Don't get so fixated on one carrier or one product that you try to make it fit where it doesn't. Number three, you don't want to get so focused on one solution or one way to solve a problem that it's the only way you can solve it. If you walk in the door with the belief that everybody is an infinite banking customer and everybody that you meet either needs to purchase whole life or IUL and they don't qualify because of health issues, you just lost the sale. If you go in with a focus and a purpose, as the top 5% do, of uniquely understanding what that client's problem is and how you are uniquely going to solve it based upon the challenges that they present to you, the opportunity that is there, and any restrictions or limitations that may exist, now you're not focusing on one solution. The only solution you're focusing on is solving the client's problem. And there's a variety of ways that you can do that. There are a number of products and services that are out there that can help your clients solve their money problems. And there is a diverse group of those for a reason. Your clients' needs are diverse, and the solutions to solve those need to be diverse as well. Remember, your clients are diverse. They come from a variety of life experience and different walks of life. Your solutions should be as unique to their problems as they are. It's not a one-size-fits-all approach. Number one, in this day and age in which we live, when we have to serve the customer and we have to make sure, as we always should have been doing, that we are acting in the customer's best interest. As their needs are diverse, your solutions need to be diverse as well. You know, your clients, as we've already said, are in multiple marketing mediums. You need to be everywhere they are. If they're a newspaper reader and that's your ideal customer, you need to periodically appear in the newspaper. If they watch television or they listen to the radio, you need to be there if that's where they're looking to find you. If they're on Facebook or Instagram, you need to be there. If they're on LinkedIn, you need to be there. If they're checking their mailbox to see if there's something important or an event they need to attend, you need to be there. That's why you need to do your homework to understand who your unique prospect is and where they go to look for education and information. That's part of the process that we take financial advisors through when they go through our attractional advisor sales training model. And we spend time working with producers that want to scale their business to understand how uniquely do that. Now, at the end of the day, it comes down to the fact that one is the onlyest number that you'll ever know. And in your business, if you want to see success, not only short-term and long-term, you've got to take the number one out of the equation. You can't just have one product. You can't just have one carrier. You can't just have one sales pitch. You've got to become more diverse in what you do. And one of the neat things about us here at Vision Advisors is we don't just do one. We don't have one unique marketing initiative that we bring to the table and try to teach every producer how to do what everybody else is doing. That's what makes us unique and different in the marketplace. We sit down with you as a financial professional, and we take you through an inventory of your skills, your knowledge, your background. We dive into and take a look at the type of clients that you're serving. And based upon that, we either will recommend one of the multiple methods that we have to help you get in front of a qualified prospect, to get in front of more qualified referrals, and to scale your practice. We may bring one of our existing solutions, or we may be better served by helping you take a message that you're already delivering and tweak that and change the way that you are presenting that or expanding opportunities there to help you generate a better outcome, or we may create something unique just for you based upon the audience that you're serving. We understand that one is the loneliest number that you're ever going to know, and we want to make sure that one is not a stumbling block for you. So if that's what you're looking for in working with an IMO that is not focused on product, but is focused on the opportunity to allow you to be marketing focused and results oriented, give us a call here at Vision Advisors. That number is 1-800-505-8489. You can also go to our website, visionadvisorsinc.com. You see it there on the screen. Scroll to the bottom of the homepage, and you can schedule a 30-minute strategy call with one of our business consultants to have an opportunity to have a conversation with them about how we can help you experience a better outcome and scale your business for a greater level of success going forward. And by the way, while you're on our website, when you get to visionadvisorsinc.com, in the upper right-hand corner, be sure and visit and like and follow us on Facebook and LinkedIn. And also, don't forget to check out our YouTube channel. Over 160 trading videos just like this are available in our library, and we're constantly adding to our library of training tips, tools, and resources that we make available to our producers. I'm John Terry with Vision Advisors. Thanks for joining me for this Selling Secrets of the Top 5%. We look forward to having a conversation with you to help you achieve a better outcome and grow your practice like you've never grown it before. Have a great day.